because I think it's important to preserve the truth. Right. I think that when something like this happens in a country, it's really important to tell the story of what happened. One of my favorite poems has this line. It's by Robert Lowell, and it says, "And yet, why not say what happened?" So I wanted to say what happened. And what happened is that this was an election that was really unforgivably flawed, and there's evidence for that. And I felt it was important to say that. But also, I wanted to call out the U.S. for what I consider a kind of two-facedness when it comes to Africa. So, you know, the U.S. has a long history of complicity in, you know, sort of non-democratic elections on this continent. So recently in Congo, 2 or 3 years ago, they endorsed an election that was an absolute sham. But then the same U.S. will turn around and criticize Congo for not being democratic. And so my point was to say, be what you say you are, right? You cannot criticize African countries. For being undemocratic, while at the same time endorsing something that is quite self-evidently undemocratic.
Well, that's a good point. But just delving deeper into your letter, you were quite categorical in saying that the electoral process was imperiled not by technical shortcomings, but by deliberate manipulation. Is there enough evidence in your assessment to support that claim?
Yes, and I think maybe the most glaring is that we Nigerians all saw these mutilated election sheets, right? We all saw them. We saw polling unit agents talking about how